Your Excellency, Russia and Ukraine have held three rounds of negotiations in Belarus so far. However, analysts say there is no substantial progress. What are the biggest obstacles in the negotiations? What do you think is the key to resolving the conflict at this point?
Yes, indeed. I have to admit that there has been little substantial progress in the negotiations. However, some results have been achieved. It is very important for both sides to meet, talk, and try to understand each other. Unfortunately, although they have found some common ground at the negotiating table, one side's position may change fundamentally again after they go back. We understand why it happens. But in any case, at least both sides are willing to talk now. It's very important. Then, what are the main obstacles? I am convinced the main obstacle is the position of the West. In violation of various international rules, treaties, and agreements, the West is trying to supply Ukraine with the most advanced weapons and send mercenaries. As the Chinese foreign minister said earlier, it is adding fuel to the fire. The main problem is that the West has always ignored Russia's concerns about regional security and NATO's repeated expansion eastward, despite its commitment not to do so. But solutions do exist. I think, first of all parties concerned need to get rid of external interference. Second, they need to sincerely look for a compromise based on a balance of interests.
What efforts has Belarus made to mediate in the conflict between Russia and Ukraine? What guarantees have you offered to both sides?
The word mediation might be a bit of an overstatement. We have not and do not intend to engage in any mediation. We are concerned and hope to find solutions at the diplomatic table, not on the battlefield, even for a crisis like this one. That's what Belarusian leaders are doing right now. I know that the President of Belarus has spoken with Russian President Putin several times. I would like to say that there was also communication between President Lukashenko and President Zelensky, which played a decisive role in organizing the entire negotiation and the beginning of the negotiation process. When the first negotiation was in jeopardy, just half an hour before the scheduled start, it can be said it was an extremely urgent situation. President Lukashenko communicated with President Zelensky instantly, and the Ukrainian delegation finally arrived at the negotiation site. So, what's our role? If we are asked what's our role and how important it is, our answer is, although we are not a party to this negotiation, we have never shied away from our responsibilities and are ready to move forward the negotiation process and contribute to resolving the current situation. Our priority now is to provide maximum assistance to the two delegations in Belarus. We are working hard to create convenient transport conditions and provide all necessary guarantees in organizing the talks. Of course, the transportation issue, creating comfortable working conditions and securing communications are important. Most importantly, the President of Belarus has ensured the safety of all negotiators during these rounds of negotiations. Therefore, we will continue to do our best to ensure that the negotiations can be successful as soon as possible.
On March 2nd, the 11th Emergency session of the United Nations General Assembly adopted a resolution demanding Russia to immediately stop these wars against Ukraine and withdraw all its military forces from the country. Five countries, including Russia, Belarus, the DPRK, Syria and Eritrea, voted against the resolution, while 35 countries, including China, India, abstained. Why did Belarus choose to oppose this resolution?
Yes, 35 countries abstained. That means they don't endorse the resolution. That is the way they decided to express their opinion, for one reason or another. Why did we vote against it? Because a simple analysis of this resolution shows that it is absolutely one-sided. It's a one-sided description of the situation in Ukraine and its surrounding areas. This resolution does not include what happened in the past 8 years before this resolution. In fact, there was a civil war. The resolution calls on all parties to abide by the Minsk agreement, although it is well known that there is one party that clearly failed to abide by the agreement reached in Minsk, but somehow, I don't know why, be it the UN Security Council, the UN General Assembly, or other UN organizations, they have never been concerned about the non-compliance of this agreement in the past 6 or 7 years. And this UN resolution has made groundless, far-fetched, and politicized accusations against Belarus. At the same time, the positive role played by Belarus in coordinating the trilateral contact group has been ignored and forgotten. Belarus's role in enhancing full cooperation with our southern neighbor has also been forgotten. Therefore, this resolution is certainly unacceptable to us, because we are convinced that it will not be conducive to the settlement of the current conflict, but will further widen the differences between the parties concerned.
Your Excellency, on March the 7th, some Western media reported that Ukraine refused to implement the Russia-proposed plan to open certain humanitarian corridors because Kiev could not accept that most Ukrainian citizens in conflict areas would then be evacuated to Russia or Belarus. Can you confirm this? What's your comment on Ukraine's reaction?
I can't confirm the veracity of the media reports, but I can quote the consul of the Ukrainian embassy in Belarus. After the Belarus foreign ministry summoned him, he told us that Ukraine would not open any humanitarian corridors leading to Russia and Belarus. Belarus is unaware of this information, but the logic of the Ukrainian leaders is completely incomprehensible to us, because Ukraine is only 100 to 200 kilometers away from the Belarus border. If the Ukrainian side is concerned about saving the lives of civilians, then considering the actual situation, it should take the most rational solution, ensuring that the shortest humanitarian corridor is opened. However, Ukraine seems to have other considerations. At present, both the Russian and Ukrainian negotiating parties attach great importance to this issue. The most important thing now is to ensure the safety of civilians and do everything possible to evacuate more people from the conflict areas. On this issue, Belarus is willing to assist any party, whether Russia or Ukraine.
According to the UN, almost 2 million people have fled Ukraine and 500 innocent civilians have been killed in the conflict. What kind of humanitarian support and assistance has Belarus provided or will provide in the near future?
Although no official humanitarian corridor has been opened, Belarus has taken in a large number of Ukrainian refugees. Ukrainian citizens, non-Ukrainians, they came to Belarus by themselves, with family members or babies in their arms, via different routes. We have provided shelter, food, and wherever possible, jobs to them.
По возможности обеспечиваются работой. Мы сделаем все, чтобы они чувствовали себя в безопасности и чувствовали себя комфортно.
We will do everything we can to create a sense of safety and comfort for them. The number of refugees has reached 3,000 and is still rising every day. The most important thing now is to reach a consensus and find a compromise solution at the negotiating table as soon as possible on the basis of balancing interests of all parties concerned. Belarus is willing to fully assist in this regard. This is most important. The Belarusian side is willing to do everything we can to repair the damage caused by the current conflict.
Восстановление разрушенных, скажем, вещей, связанных с нынешней конфликтной ситуацией.
My last question, Your Excellency, how would you assess China's role and position since the beginning of the conflict?
Нам кажется, что позиция Китая весьма взвешенная, выдержанная.
In our view, China's position has been prudent and consistent. The statements by the entire Chinese leadership, from the President of the People's Republic of China to the Foreign Minister and Chinese government spokesperson, have all demonstrated the commitment to resolve this conflict at the negotiating table in a peaceful manner as soon as possible.
Мирным, спокойным путем за столом переговоров. Это совпадает с нашими подходами.
That's in line with our stance, and we're ready to collaborate with this great country to find a solution to this crisis.
Данной кризисной ситуации.
Thank you very much, Vladimir Makei, the Foreign Minister of Belarus.